As all of you are aware, the Honorable Prime Minister launched the Prime Minister Gati Shakti National Master Plan in October 2021. And in these 1.5 years, a lot of progress has been made and we are getting very good results. As you are aware, this is a data-based GIS system which is to be used for holistic planning, multimodal connectivity infrastructure, and for bringing logistics efficiency in the country using objective data for decision making. Now, the data has been put in place. It has been used by various ministries of Government of India for planning their projects, duly optimizing the principles of Gati Shakti. And what are these principles? That there should be multimodal connectivity of infrastructure leading to an efficient logistics ecosystem. In order to support the Gati Shakti National Master Plan, the Honorable Prime Minister also launched the National Logistics Policy a couple of months back in September last year. And that is to make our businesses more competitive and make sure that the services which are related to infrastructure lead to a cost-effective logistics ecosystem. So in that context, two important things have been done at Government of India level. One is the Network Planning Group, which sits and evaluates all major infrastructure projects of Government of India, whether they be rail projects or they be road projects or telecom or power or pertaining to ports, inland waterways or any of the other infrastructure ministries. And what do we evaluate? We sit and see the planning of the project. All the infrastructure ministries sit and they see whether the railway line which is being proposed or the road which is being proposed meets multimodal connectivity criteria. So if there are economic zones, the road must connect all the economic zones. It must connect the major places of tourism, of economic growth in the area. Similarly, there should be no last mile connectivity issues with respect to airports, with respect to railways. If there are manufacturing zones, raw material needs to come in, finished goods need to go out. So there should be good connectivity to ports, good connectivity to the raw material producing areas of the country, good connectivity to the markets as the manufacturing goods flow out. And these markets could be within the country or they could be export markets. Hence, the manufacturing zones are being connected, much better connected, duly taking care of critical infrastructure gaps to the ports and to the different marketplaces. In this way, we are strengthening our supply chains in the country. And in this way, we are making our country and the logistics ecosystem more attractive for investments, whether they come from within the country or these are foreign investments. When logistics cost is low because of logistics efficiency, which is promoted by both building of infrastructure and by giving better services related to logistics and through multimodal connectivity, it is then that our goods which are made in the country become more globally competitive. That is when we support Make in India, that is when we support Atmanirbhar Bharat more ably. So this is the entire spirit. Now, as I said, very good results are already being seen and 66 major infrastructure cases have been evaluated by the Network Planning Group in the last 1 year or so. These 66 cases are valued at about 5 lakh rupees, and these are all cases where planning has been done on the Gati Shakti National Master Plan, duly promoting multimodal connectivity, duly promoting any connectivity, bridging the connectivity gaps to the various infrastructure projects. So this has been done by Government of India. We wanted to share these cases with the states. We want to encourage more usage of the Gati Shakti concept by the states, by the union territories. And in this context, we've already had two workshops, and this is the third workshop. With this workshop, we would have covered about 15 states of the country and about 8 union territories. And we are seeing very encouraging results from the states as well. They are also sharing how they are using the Gati Shakti State Master Plan on the principles of the Prime Minister Gati Shakti program. Today we heard from Jammu Kashmir how they have planned the ICD at Samba using the Gati Shakti principles. Similarly, cold storages have been mapped so that there are no critical infrastructure gaps in terms of movement of goods, multimodal logistics parks, all-weather road connectivity, and very impressively, the pharma units, 64 pharma units in Kathua Industrial Zone, or the location, the connectivity issues have been studied on the Prime Minister Gati Shakti portal. Similarly, Chandigarh has shared with us how they are rolling out the 5G network entirely using the planning tools on the Gati Shakti portal. Delhi has shared with us the plan, dig and monitoring app, which is using the spatial data of the Gati Shakti portal. Himachal Pradesh is planning its tourist related strategy and also the upcoming industrial zones using the Gati Shakti principle. That is, all the roads should connect to these industrial zones. The railway lines should be connected to the roads, the state highways to the national highways. So everything should be connected for the seamless movement of freight. Uttarakhand has shared with us how they are planning all their projects of 25 crore and above using the Gati Shakti principles. Rajasthan is planning transport zones, warehousing, location of warehousing zones, and it is also attracting private investment. They have prepared projects to attract private investment in infrastructure projects related to logistics. Punjab has shared with us how it has mapped the black spots where there is traffic hazard on the master plan, so that they can bring improvement to infrastructure at these points. So in these various ways, different states have shared their experiences. Ladakh has also, we have seen a case in the morning where Morth has told us how they have planned all weather connectivity to areas of Ladakh. So all this has been discussed and we have learned from each other. We are receiving feedback from the states and UTs where they want more support, whether it be in terms of technical handholding or it be in terms of sharing of how to go about developing better tools for planning on the national master plan. So this is a little brief from my side. Tomorrow we are going to discuss the national logistics policy and how the logistics policies are being developed by the different states and union territories. We've heard some good inputs today, but tomorrow we will be totally focused on the logistics policy and how the states and UTs are going forward on that.